Hi everyone, my name is Najele, blogger at Trends and Blends Ghana and the model for today. So before we start, you can follow me on Instagram at Trends and Blends Ghana. You can like my page at Trends and Blends Ghana on Facebook. And I love this look that Lamisi has created for me today. So enjoy the video. Don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Subscribe for updates and stay fam. Thank you.
This is the flat edge brush by Evita Joseph. I'll be using this brush to define Nas brows, and I'm going to clean out all the marks created outside her natural brow line with a concealer. And the concealer I'm using today is the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Fawn and Toast, which I mixed together to create Nas perfect color. To further define her brows, I'll be using the Evita Joseph Precision Concealer brush. What it does is to define her brows and then erase all harsh marks created by the concealer.
Now moving on, I'll be using the Evita Joseph Diffuse Blender Brush together with my transition color, which is from BH Cosmetics. I'll be using that on her crease to create a soft finishing for the eyeshadow that will be on the eyelid itself. And that is it. The main thing is to blend and then keep blending. But the trick here is to fetch the eyeshadow little by little, because once you pack everything on, it's very difficult to blend. So I'll just pack it on little by little.
Since I'm going for a smoky eye, I'm using this brown or dark brown color to further enhance the crease. I don't want to use the burgundy because it's just going to create a different look. So I want to maintain the blackness with the eyeshadow. That is why I'm using this dark brown eyeshadow for the transition. For today's eyeshadow base, I'll be using the NYX Jumbo Pencil and the color is Black Bean or something like that. And I'm using this to serve as a base for the eyeshadow. Since I'm going for a smoky eye, I feel it's even better using a black base. Now I'm using this black eyeshadow, which has a bit of sparkle in it, and that is what I'm using for the main eyelid. And the eyeshadow is from the Morphe 35W eyeshadow palette, and I'm packing it gently onto the eyelid because it has some sparkles or glitters inside the eyeshadow, and I wouldn't want it to fall onto her face. So I'm packing it gently and bit by bit. I'm also blending it out with a blending brush. This brush is more of an eyeshadow brush, but I feel it works very well when you're blending, when you're using it as a blender. So I'm just using it to blend out the eyeshadow, the black eyeshadow, together with a transition color. Well, this is the City Color Photo Chic Primer, and I'm going to use this to prime Jessica's face because her face is very oily. I'm going in with the Victor Joseph Ultimate Face Buffer, and that is what I'm going to use for the foundation application. I'm using this together with my MAC Mash Master foundation, and her color is 8.5.
To highlight set the high points of her face, I'll be using the LA Girl Bro Concealer in the color Fawn and Toast, which I mixed together to get her exact shade. Now, the best tool for this process is the Evita Joseph Beauty Blender. This blender gives you the best results and then gives you the very flawless effect you're looking for. So I'll be using that for this particular look, and there you have it. To set the concealer, I'll be using my Saksha Buttercup powder, and I'm going to use this powder on every part of her face that I concealed, and that is under her eyes, on the bridge of her nose, her forehead, her cupid's bow. And I'm going to move straight into contouring. I'll be using my Coastal Scents eyeshadow for contouring together with my Evita Joseph Precision Blusher. This is a blush brush, but I prefer and then I like to use it for contouring as well. So it has dual functions for me. And yeah, that's it. I'll be setting the whole of her face with the Black Radiance Finishing Powder. And the tools I'm going to use would be Evita Joseph Powder Buffer and the You Spicy Brush. I'm using these two brushes because the You Spicy Brush is fluffy and it's used to dust off the excess powder under her eyes and all the other areas that I have set. And for the proper application of the powder, I'll be using the Evita Joseph Powder Buffer, which is very good for powder application, and then it creates a flawless effect. For bronzing today, I'll be using the Black Up Sublime powder together with the Evita Joseph Classic Highlight brush, and this is going to be used on the high points of her cheeks, the bridge of her nose, her forehead and her chin, and this is just to create some sort of glow for her. I'm picking this burgundy shade from the BH Cosmetics Neutral Palette, and I'm just using this to give Nars some color. I'm going to move straight into the lipstick application. Today I'll be using MAC lipstick, which is called the Huggable Lip Color Commotion, and it has some gloss in it that is just to pop her lips. We're done with the final look, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, keep your comments coming, and follow Nar on Instagram at trendsandblends.com. That is her fashion blog. Thank you so much for watching. Mm-hmm.